Okay, welcome to another video by Ferris Technology. Today we're going to go over the code window and the things that you can do in the code window to make your life a lot easier and simpler. So let's get started. So the first thing I want to go over is the fact that in VBA, white space just doesn't matter. So in our first example here, the white space around these statements don't make any real difference. In fact, I could put an extra line here. I could even put end function clear down at the bottom, and the code would run the same no matter what. So what you want to do then is you want to indent and you want to be able to show your code in the most readable way possible. And you don't need to worry about using the white space because that'll all be collapsed when it goes to running it. Now, the next thing I want to share with you is about line space continuation. Now, here's an example of a typical line that just goes off the page. In other words, I needed to do more in that line. Now, if I just say, gosh, I'd like this on the next line. If I go just like that, it's going to say, I don't know what to do with it. Access wants to see the end of a line before it compiles. So because it doesn't like that, it's going to tell you by making it red, you put a space, and then if you put an underscore there, it allows the line to continue to the next line. Okay, and then I can go here and do the same thing here. And of course, it's going to yell at me. And then I'm going to put a space and an underscore here. And then on this last quoted part, I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing and put an underscore here. And you do have to put a space and then the underscore. Missed the space there. So with a space and an underscore at the end of each line, that's what they call a line continuation. It allows you to take a long line and break it up into various pieces so that it can be easily read because it's not going off the screen to the right. Now, just like you can break up long lines, you can also take very short lines and add them to each other, and they're actually treated as separate lines. And that's done down here with the colon. The colon allows me, in this case, I have 9 variables to create a value to. I've dimensioned them up here, and I want to give a value to them down here, but I don't want to spend 9 more lines pushing all my other code down to display all of those initializations. So in that case, I'll use a colon and I'll actually initialize 3 different variables on the same line. And by doing so, I compress my code and allow it to be much more readable. All right, so the next example I want to show you is how access will help you when you're writing code in the code window. For example, I want to write a do command here that I know will open a form. You usually have to put do command in front of what you'd want to have done, opening a form, a report, or other actions. But here is, if I hold down the control key and hit the space bar, do command is on a list of various things that I could start my statement with. And it's at the top. So I'm going to take my mouse and double click on it to start there. And then I'm going to put dot here, and it gives me a whole bunch of things that the do command will do for me. And really here, I want to open a form, okay? And there it comes to the top when I get to the F. I'll double click this. And when I hit the space bar, it gives me some help as to what to do. Now, in this case, it tells me what to put in there, but doesn't necessarily tell me exactly what the syntax should be. The syntax actually, even though they're telling me that I need a form name and then I need to tell whether it's the view is going to be normal or any other form, any other type of view, I still need to type it in the quotes, or else it's just not going to know what to do. So I have a form contacts that I want to open, and I want to close that in quotes and hit the space bar again. And now it automatically gives me a listing, gives me some quick info as to the constants that I can use for the open form action there. And those are, you know, I can put it in layout view, I can put it in normal view, I can put it in design view. I can use this function to open it in design view to be designed. In my case, I'm just going to put it in normal view. And that's really the end of my statement there. When I click out of it, you can tell that it accepted it well because it puts it all in the format that Access likes to see it. It even added some white space here. You notice that AC normal moved out to the right, and it capitalizes the open form. It makes it look the way it finally needs to look. The last thing to learn here is that once you're done with a code, and if you've hand typed a lot of your code in here, you might want to make sure that it compiles. So if you run up here to debug, you can hit this compile, and it'll give you the name of the database here. I've called this one Learning VBA. And so I can click on compile. And if it doesn't give you any feedback, that means it's good. You can know that for sure by clicking debug, and it'll be grayed out. So you know that it's already been compiled. It just lets you know that you don't really want to compile it again. Okay? So if you've gotten some good information out of this video, please hit the like button and get it out to more people. And if you can subscribe to us, the channel would be most grateful. Thank you. Talk to you later.